This video is brought to you by AKSIAS.
Hello students, welcome to AKSIAS. This video is made on the AKSIAS material which covers the year-round current affairs related to the topic of science and technology. In this video, we'll look into some of the topics given in this material briefly. Our first topic is Defence Space Agency. Recently, government took a decision to establish Defence Space Agency, which will be entrusted with the task of creating space warfare weapon systems and related technologies. See, different governments such as US and China are trying to develop space weapons. In that context, it is necessary for India to have or to acquire minimum credible offensive capacity in the space defense. That is why Space Defense Agency or Defense Space Agency has been created. It will be entrusted with the task of creating space warfare weapons. In that context, it is important for us to know what is it and what is our capability of India in the space warfare. That is the present capability of India in the space warfare. All of them have been given in the material in detail. Here, the role of the DSA, that is what this Defense Space Agency will do in the future, all of them have been given in the material. The probable main question that can be given is, space has undoubtedly become a military theater. India's policy goal should change from having a space presence to being a space power. Discuss. See, India has been using its space technologies only in the civilian domain. That is for telecommunication, weather monitoring, weather broadcasting, etc., etc. But it is not using its space technologies in the defense field. So the question is asking, what the question is giving is, India should change its policy to become a space power. So in that context, creating this Defense Space Agency may be one step in that, you know, in that line. So that is why this question has been given here. So this information given in the material can be very useful for this question, for answering this question. Our next topic is related to Integrated Guided Missile Development Plan. See, the probable or the very expected question from this topic is, which are the missile systems that have been developed under the Integrated Guided Missile Development Plan? So there are basically five missile systems which are developed under this program. Those include Agni, Prithvi, Nag, and Akash and Trishul. So these are the five missile systems that have been developed under the program called Integrated Guided Missile Development Plan. Another thing that we need to know about this program is that it is based on indigenous development of missile systems. See, prior to this, we used to, you know, procure these missile systems from the other countries such as Russia and Israel. We even now procure them from the other countries, but the aim of this program was to create the or to manufacture the indigenous missile systems. See, here it has been given, Integrated Guided Missile Development Plan has been envisioned in 1983 by the former President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, to help India attain self-sufficiency, that is, to manufacture the missile systems indigenously without depending upon any other country. So, the five missile systems have been given here. And in 2008, DRDO announced the successful completion of the program. In the material, all the missiles and their features have been listed out. All the different missile systems have been listed out in the material. See, from the prelims perspective, we need to remember a few things. Those include, what is the range of a missile system, whether it is a surface-to-surface missile system or surface-to-air, whether it can carry nuclear warheads or not. All of them have been given in the material. For each one of it, we have to remember what kind it is. Our next topic is military exercises. So it is important for us to remember the name of the military exercise and the country with which that particular exercise has been carried out. So these are important. From that perspective, different military exercises have been listed out here. So Equivarent with Maldives, Nomadic Elephant with Mongolia, Kajin with Kazakhstan, Maitri with Thailand, Dharma Guardian with Japan, IM Annex 2019 which is India Myanmar Naval Exercise, Shakti 2019 with France. It is a military exercise. See, there are different kinds: military exercises, naval exercises, and Air Force exercises also been carried out. So we need to remember with the same country, India can carry out military exercise as well as naval exercise as well as Air Force exercise. So these three things can have different names. We need to remember all of them. Next, the Defense Acquisition Council has approved the indigenous construction of 6 submarines for the Indian Navy at the cost of over 40,000 crores under the Strategic Partnership Model. So here we need to know what is Defense Acquisition Council and what is Strategic Partnership Model. So Defense Acquisition Council is the highest decision making body under the Defense Ministry, which takes the decisions on new policies with respect to defense and new procurements, new capital procurements with respect to defense. All of these decisions are taken by this Defense Acquisition Council. This Defense Acquisition Council is chaired by the Defense Minister. Now, what is Strategic Partnership Model? See, Strategic Partnership Model basically aims to make India the defense manufacturing hub. This particular model is in line with the Make in India program of India. What Strategic Partnership Model does is, it allows the partnership between the two private companies in the field of defense. See, that is, the original equipment manufacturer, which are situated outside India, that is in the foreign countries, and the strategic partner from the India, that is Indian private companies. Allowing partnership of these two private entities to manufacture defense equipment. So this is what basically is Strategic Partnership Model. Its objective is to encourage defense manufacturing within India. Now, coming to the context, so the Defense Acquisition Council has approved the indigenous construction under the Strategic Partnership Model of 6 submarines for Indian Navy. So this construction under the name Project 75, the construction of 6 submarines have been approved in the Strategic Partnership Model. That is the context. Under the name Project 75, India is procuring 6 Scorpion submarines from the France. So this is different. The Project 75 I is different from the Project 75. The details of the project have been listed out here. Next, Barak missile. See, Barak missile is a result of joint venture of India and Israel. This we need to remember. And it is a long range surface to air missile. So other details, other features have been listed out here. Now we are moving to biotechnology. See, under this, our first topic is CRISPR-Cas9. See, from the prelims perspective, we need to know what is the CRISPR means, what is Cas9. Actually, last year in the prelims it has been asked. So the CRISPR means CRISPR, clustered regularly interspaced short palindromic repeats. Cas9 is a CRISPR associated protein 9. So it's basically an enzyme which act as a molecular scissors. It cuts the DNA at a specified locations. This CRISPR is the specified location. This Cas9 protein cuts the DNA at that particular, at that specified location. So it basically gene editing tool. So we need to know what is CRISPR, what is Cas. We don't need to go in deep. Understanding is important, but we don't need to go in deep. See, as has been discussed, it cuts here the specified location and it helps edit genes. Other related information also been given here. If needed, you can read. See, there may not be direct question from what is CRISPR, what is Cas9 in the mains. It is very technical, but the question can be, what are the implications of it, the ethical implications? So because it aims at, you know, gene editing, it helps gene editing. So there are just many other concerns related to that. We can expect questions. All of them as well given here, advantages, disadvantages. The probable mains question, discuss about the CRISPR gene editing technology and the concerns raised by the gene editing technology. See, this is the most important part. This is very small part of the question. Our next topic is three-parent baby. This particular topic I'll explain in detail. Before talking about this topic, we need to have some idea of other concepts. First, I'll explain them. See, this is human cell. This is nucleus, which contains genetic material or the chromosomes, and these are organelles. See, in a body we call different parts as organs, in a cell we call different parts as organelles. So these are different kinds of organelles: lysosomes, mitochondria, Golgi apparatus. Likewise, there are different organelles inside the cell. So this is the genetic material, that is the chromosomes. So this we need to remember. See, humans are formed from one single cell called zygote. See, in the zygote, they contains 23 pairs of chromosomes. One set of 23 come from father, one set come from mother. So this zygote has organelles, as we saw earlier. It also has organelles such as mitochondria, lysosomes, Golgi apparatus, etc., etc. These particular organelles come from mother, that is only from mother. Father contributes only the one set of 23 chromosomes. Mother contributes one set of 23 chromosomes as well as the different organelles of the cell. See, this genetic material, that is these 23 pairs of chromosomes, are the reason for our characteristics, that is hair color, body color, eye shape or height, skin type, etc., etc. All different characteristics, intelligence, you know, everything, every character is given by these 23 pairs, which are come from the father and mother. But there is another kind of genetic material, which is located on mitochondria. See, mitochondria is an organelle. The mitochondria, which came from mother, also contains some part of genetic material. It also codes for few characters. See, this is the most important genetic material, it contributes to most of the characteristics. But the genetic material which is located on mitochondria contributes to very few characteristics. Due to the defects in the genetic material located on mitochondria, it causes different genetic diseases such as Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's, Huntington's disease, etc. If mother is found to have such diseases, it is for sure that next generation will carry such type of diseases. So to avoid such a situation, What can be done is, see, these 23 pairs contributed by the both the parents, that is father and mother, can be transferred into the another egg cell which has been taken from a healthy healthy woman. See, egg cell contains 23, one set of 23, not 23 pairs, but 23 chromosomes and all other organelles, including mitochondria. These 23 pairs are taken from the parents, from father and mother. This particular 23 is taken out and this will be introduced here. Now, the genetic material for the baby which is come from this zygote will have from this mother, this father, as well as the donor of this egg cell. So it counts to be three parents. That is why the three parent baby, that is why it is called as three parent baby. So the context here is, recently a team of Greek and Spanish doctors has produced a baby from three people using maternal spindle transfer technique. It is done through two techniques, that spindle transfer and pronuclear transfer. This is what, that is what we, you know, talked about, removing this and introducing this, these two techniques, using these two techniques, you know, this three parent baby has been produced for the first time by the Greek and Spanish doctors. I hope you understood the concept. In the material, the it has been given in detail what is the need for three parent baby. All of them have been given, and it has also been given from the mains perspective, what is the process behind this three parent baby, all of them, and also advantages related to that and issues associated with three parent baby, such as ethical issues, safety implications, social issues, etc., etc. So next concept is Project Manav. See, it's basically a human atlas. It basically tries to, you know, locate which tissue locates where and which organ, all these kinds of things in detail, you know, inch to inch. So this is basically, it is undertaken to, you know, understand the roles of different kinds of tissues and cells, and it's their links to various kinds of diseases. So this is the crux, and it has been, you know, undertaken by the Department of Biotechnology. It is important for prelims. Our next topic is related to BT Brinjal. See, it is in the news in the context that genetically modified crops activist in Haryana alleged that a farmer had been cultivating BT Brinjal since years. See, this raises many questions. See, if this farmer is, you know, cultivating the BT Brinjal since years, it means it has been already introduced into the market. What were the health implications? Because the health implications of the genetically modified crops is unknown. That is why these genetically modified crops have become, you know, controversial. So in that context, it is important. It is important for us to know what is genetically modified crop. So it's basically, you know, involves the inserting of DNA into the genome of organism. See, for some, BT is Bacillus thuringiensis, which is a pest which produces, you know, pest resistant chemical by the plant, so that the pests are don't attack the plants, which will increase the production or the produce of the plant. So that is why this particular genetically modified crops has been developed. So in that context, it is important for us to understand what it is and all such related things, and these have been given here, its implications, different kinds of implications, food security, human health risks, etc., etc. Here, the environmental concerns. So all have been detailed out here in the material. Next, DNA Regulation Bill. DNA Technology Use and Application Regulation Bill was introduced in Lok Sabha. That is why it is discussed here. See, by now it would have become very clear for you that we have been discussing about three parent baby, BT cotton, BT Brinjal and CRISPR-Cas9, all such, you know, technologies are involving DNA. So there is need for some regulation. That is why this bill has been brought and it was introduced in Lok Sabha. So here in the material, it has been discussed and it has been, you know, described at length, from what is DNA to what the bill, you know, is talking about, what the bill is trying to regulate, what are the advantages, what are the disadvantages, what is missing out in the bill. All of them have been detailedly given in the material. You can go through the material for that. Here it has been given the different things that this bill is trying to establish. Various other things also been detailed out here. It has been discussed at length, from what is DNA to the loopholes or the missing out factors in the bill. All of them have been given, the way forward is been given, and the prospective mains question also been given here, that is, write the provisions of DNA bill, how the bill fails in arresting the crimes, criticisms of the bill. All of them have been given here. With this, we'll conclude our discussion on the year on current affairs related to science and technology. We'll see some more topics in the next video. Thank you so much.